Hello everyone, wishing you a very good afternoon. Am I audible and visible to everyone? Am I audible, visible? Good afternoon, Yarika. I get doubt when you don't respond whether I am visible or audible or not. Good afternoon, Tanu. Good to see you back. I hope you are fine. You were not responding in yesterday's class. I was a bit worried. What's wrong? I hope you are good. Good afternoon, Abhiram. Okay. Good. Good to see you back, Tanu. And your nice DP. Why you have put this black DP with red horns? Okay. Must be some reason. You must be liking it. Anyways. What was that we discussed in the last class? I think we had discussed the equation of trajectory in the last class. And we had seen some questions. We had solved some question. And I had also given one question as homework, which I'm very glad to say that Niharika did it and put it on the group. A bit disappointed that I could not get other answers as well. Abhiram, you can join from your PC. I don't know what stops you from doing that. I don't see any login, any request coming from your ID. I only see one Abhiram here. You can, it's a Zoom meeting. I think you can join from a webcam, from a laptop also. I don't think that would be a problem. If you have the link, and I would, in fact, want all of you to probably join from a laptop, or if you have a mobile, you can also screen your mobile on your TV monitors so that you can see the lecture on a big screen. I look better. I might not look better on a big screen, not even on a small screen, but the thing that I do on the whiteboard, they will look a lot better if you have a bigger screen. I always told you that, right? So if you have, you can always use them. Okay. Not a problem, Abhiram. You can join afterwards from your laptop. You can always do that. Okay. In today's class, what we are going to discuss is a concept which is known as, we talked about that concept in the last class, I guess. Does anyone remember what we were supposed to discuss today? Does anyone remember? Does anyone recollect? What are we supposed to discuss today? If my memory serves me right, I had seen, or we had seen, a question which confused us, which did not have any x in that equation. We had seen an equation of trajectory which did not have any x, and then we found out. Yes, Niharika, something of that nature. We found out that if there is no x, that means the angle of projection is zero. Now, if the angle of projection is zero, that means I will project something on ground. Now, if I project something on ground, that will not move in air, that will move along ground. So how can I get equation of trajectory for something which is projected along ground? The case is not like that. The case is different. If I have angle of projection as zero, that type of projectile is known as a horizontal projectile. That type of projectile is known as a horizontal projectile. Now, what is a horizontal projectile? Up till now, whatever projectile we did was known as, what was the name of the projectile that we did up till now? It was known as oblique projectile. Why it was known as oblique? Because I was throwing it at an angle. So we can broadly define the projectile to three categories. Actually, it is one category only, but we can call them by three names. One is oblique, where you throw it at an angle. I throw it at an angle, theta. One, you can call it as vertical projection. Vertical projection. And vertical projection, what will I do? I will throw it at an angle of 90 degrees. vertically upwards. Where did we see this type of projectile? Where did we see this type of projectile? We definitely saw it in motion in 1D. Do we remember this? We discussed this projectile in motion in 1D. Yes, Nihari, we did it. Then we can call the third type of projectile, which is the topic of discussion today, horizontal. Horizontal projectile. Now, see, physics is very simple. It's logical, it's simple. What do you mean by horizontal projectile? It's very simple to understand that now I'm going to project, this is my x-axis. Now I'm going to project or throw the projectile like this. But again, if I throw it on ground like this, it will not go in air. So I'll not have to throw it from ground. So in all the cases of horizontal projectile or horizontal projection, it has to be projected from a height. It has to be projected from a height. Are we getting this? It has to be projected from a height. That means the case would be like this. This would be my ground. This would be some tower or some hill, which would have some height h. Up till now, we had done this problem of throwing something from height h. But in that case, either I was throwing it vertically upwards, or I was dropping it, or I was throwing it vertically downwards. Now I'm going to throw it how? I am going to throw it like this. This type of projectile is known as horizontal projectile. Can I have some raised hand that we've understood this? So we understand what do you mean by zero projection angle. You'll have to go on top of something, tower or your balcony or your terrace or a hill or Burj Khalifa or Himalayas, and then throw something horizontally. Now the point of discussion here is, how will this move? There is no doubt on this, that it will move like this. It will move like this. And it will follow a path. What type of path will this be? Again, this is taking place, motion under gravity, and it is thrown at an angle zero. This will also be part of a parabola. Yes or no? Yes or no? This will also be a part of a parabola. Yes or no? Do we understand this? Can I have some raise hand? Now, if you want to understand it, you can understand it like this also. You can assume that it was not thrown from here or this point O. This is the point operation O. You can think of it as it was from somewhere here, O dash. It was thrown from O dash. It reaches its maximum height. At maximum height, the velocity becomes horizontal only. Remember that? Do you remember that? So you can see, previously it was a full path. Now the path becomes half. Do we understand this? Can I have some raised hands just so we understand this? It is half now. It is half of the projectile now. Up till now we were doing full projectile. Now it is half of the projectile. Do we understand this? Can I have some raised hands? How did I get it half? It is just like, instead of throwing it from ground, I am throwing it from the top of the maximum height and I am throwing it horizontally. Got my point, everyone? Did you get my point? So it is just like a half projectile, and hence its path must be path of a parabola. Okay, now how will I solve this? Now what are the things? What are the known things that we know here? What are the known quantities? The known quantities usually would be the initial velocity of projection u and height h. You will probably know these two quantities. Obviously, you know the value of g. So u, h, and g will be the known quantities. What would be the unknown quantities that you might be asked to find out? Anyone, what would be the unknown quantities? What would be the unknown quantities that you might be asked to find here? What would be the unknown quantity? The first unknown quantity will be T. What would be T? T would be the time of flight here. Are you getting my point? T would be the time of flight here. Do we understand this? The time it remains in air. Can I have raised hand that we understand this, sir? Time of flight could be one of the questions that could be asked. After how much time will it fall down? Nayan, Abhiram, Akshay, Niharika, Tanu, Tarun, Vasant, Surya, are we there? Am I audible and visible to everyone? Am I audible? Am I audible and visible? Hello? Can you hear me? Can you wave your hands? I mean, can you raise your hands that you can hear me? I'm getting confused that whether you are able to hear me or not. Okay, so the known quantities are U, H, and G. The unknown quantities are time of flight, T, and what else? It will fall on ground. It will cover some distance, X. So this X would be your unknown number two. This X would be your unknown number two. And we call this unknown X as horizontal range. Same number, same type of range. This X is known as the horizontal range. So basically, there are two unknowns here. One is how much time it takes. Number two, where it falls. The value of X. What are the known quantities? The known quantities are u, initial velocity, h, the height from which it is thrown, and g, which is acceleration due to gravity. Can I have some reason that we have understood the question? And now we'll try to find out how we are going to solve this. Raise hand will give me much confidence that we are there on the same platform. We understand what are the known quantities. We understand what are the unknown quantities. And our task would be to find out the value of unknown quantities from the known ones. Good one. So let us start our endeavor of finding the solution. So here is my question. I've thrown it from the height h with an initial velocity u. And what happens is very simple. It just falls like this. So what I need to find out is the value of time of flight t and the value of this x, which is nothing but equal to r. Yes or no? We are on the same platform. And how do I do it? The next question is, how do I do it? Do I have a magic wand in my hands that I'll wave it and I'll get the answer? How will I get the answer to this one, anyone? How will I find the value? Yes, Niharika, well done, beta. The only magic wand that I have is equations of motion. So I'll apply equations of motion. Well done. Well said. Niharika, very proud of you. Equation of motion. Apply it. Where? Equation of motion. Apply it where? Along which direction? Along which axis? The number one is x-axis. Yes or no? Number one is x-axis. Equation of motion applied along x-axis. Let us write what we know. How much is the initial velocity along x? How much is the initial velocity along x? Look at the diagram. How much is the initial velocity along x? It is simply plus u. Do we get this? Plus before, because it is in the positive direction, let me call this point as origin O and this point as A. So we are applying equation from O to A. Am I clear with this point? We are applying equation from O to A on x-axis. Raise hand will give me much confidence that we are on the same platform. Raise hands, okay. Acceleration along x, we always know is zero. It is zero. Time small t is capital T, which is the time of flight. I assume that the time of flight is t. Yes or no? So basically, I know the value of ux. I know the value of acceleration. I have taken time as t. I need to find out x. Which equation should I apply? Which equation should I apply? Next question, which equation should I apply? What is the answer? Which equation should I apply? Ut is plus half gt square is the correct equation. So I apply it. I apply that equation. X will be equal to ux into t plus half ax into t squared. Listen to me very carefully, beta. T square likhna tha, t squared. Now look at here, acceleration along x is zero. So this term goes away. This term goes away. I have assumed that the x ka value is r, x is r, ux is plus u, and time is capital T. So I have written everything and I get one equation. I had to find out the value of r. I had to find out the value of t. What I have achieved here is one equation. But there are two unknowns here. What are the two unknowns? Unknown number one is r. We don't know how much is r. Unknown number two is t. I don't know t. There are two unknowns, but one known. Can I solve this equation? Can I solve this equation, which has two unknowns, but one equation? Yes, beta, we can't solve it. So what do I do next? What do I do next? I'll have to make one more equation. I'll have to make one more equation. Along which axis I'm going to make that equation? Along which axis I'm going to make that equation? Along which axis I'm going to make that equation? Yes, beta, I am going to make this equation along y-axis. Y-axis. From where to where? From O to A. I am going to make this equation from O to A along y-axis. Can you tell me what is the equation? First, to understand that equation, I will first write the known quantities. What are the known quantities that we have? What are the known quantities that we have? Initial velocity along y. How much is the initial velocity along y? Look at the diagram. It is thrown horizontally. It is thrown horizontally. So what is the vertical velocity at point O? What is the vertical velocity at point O? Anyone? It is zero. Because it is thrown horizontally. It is just like it is on the top of its maximum height. When it is at the top of its maximum height, the horizontal velocity is zero. The vertical velocity is zero. Do we understand this? Can I have some raise hand that the vertical velocity is zero? We see it, sir. Right. Vertical velocity is zero. What about acceleration along y? Acceleration along y is minus g. Why it is written as minus g? Because it is downwards and we have to take directions. What about time? Time is capital T. We have also assumed it. Time is capital T. Now we know initial velocity. Now we know acceleration. Now we time. Now we know time. We also know how much is the displacement. How much it has displaced. Y. See, it has gone from O to A. The displacement is downwards and it is equal to h. Don't we know it? The displacement is downwards and it is equal to h. The displacement is downwards and equal to h, so I'll write it as minus h. Do we know this? Do we understand this? Initial velocity along y is zero. Acceleration is minus g, minus because it is downwards. Time is capital T, and y, displacement along y-axis is minus h. Which equation will I use? Which equation will I use? I will use equation number two. What is equation number two? What is equation number two? Y is equal to uy into t plus half ay into t squared. Do we remember this equation? Do we understand this equation? Can I have some raised hand that we understand this equation, sir? Okay, I put the values. I put the values. Y is minus h. This is zero, so this goes away. Plus is equal to minus half g t squared. Minus minus getting cancelled. So I get t squared is equal to 2g by h. T squared is 2. Oops, I wrote it wrongly. It's 2h by g. So time becomes root over 2h by g. Do we understand this? How I got the value of time? Time is 2 times h by g. I got it using the equation of projectile along y-axis. Can I have some raised hand that will give me confidence that, sir, we understand this? Raised hand will give me confidence. Okay. Good one. Everyone understands this? Okay. Okay. Now, once you get the value of t, you can put the value of t from here into this equation. So you'll get the value of r as u multiplied by t. T is root over 2h by g. And hence, you got the value of range as well as you got the value of time. Then you can relax because you have got both of your answers. Am I clear? Do we understand this, everyone? Can I have some raised hand that we understand this, sir? Okay, so again, I'll repeat. How did I do this question? I first drew the diagram, saw u is horizontal, plot the unknown as t, and x is written as r, the height it moves, the displacement along y-axis is h, downward direction minus h. I wrote the equation of motion along x-axis and y-axis. From x-axis, I got one equation, r is equal to plus u into t. If I know t, I can get the value of r. How can I get the value of t? I write the equation along y-axis. Uy is zero, ay is minus g. Small t, the time is capital T. I assume it is capital T. Displacement is minus h. Because it is downwards, I put the value, I get the value of time as 2h by g. Once I get the value of time, I put it in the value of range and I get the value of range. Can you solve a question now? Can I give you a question now? Are we ready for a question? Okay, so here is the question. A ball is thrown horizontally from top of a tower of height 20 meters with velocity 10 meters per second. Find after what time it hits ground and where. So two questions are asked, where it hits the ground and after how much time. G has to be taken as 10 meter per second square. Here is the question. I hope everyone understands the question. Ball is thrown horizontally from the top of a tower 20 meters high with a velocity 10 meter per second. You have to tell me where and after how much time does it fall. I'll give you 2 minutes to solve this question. I hope you can get me the answer. I'm waiting for your answers. I will just draw the diagram so that everyone understands what are we supposed to do. This is a tower. Initial velocity u is given as 10 meters. You can call it plus because of the thing. And the height of the tower is given as 20 meters. It will fall like this. So you have to find out the time of flight and the value of x, which is the range. Can you do that for me? Do you want me to do it or you can do it? Shall I do it or you are trying it? Okay, I think you are trying. I'll wait for you. Anyone with an answer? Okay, I'll do it for you. First question I'll do. Then I will expect you to do this. First, I'll make equation along x-axis. What are the things I know along x-axis? Ux is plus 10. Ax is 0. Time, let us call as t. The equation I use will be x is equal to ux into t plus half ax into t squared x is 0, so this goes away. X becomes r is equal to ux becomes plus 10 multiplied by t. If I know the value of t, I would get the value of r. Do we understand this? Can I have raised hands here? Can we understand this, sir? We have applied equation along x-axis. That is what we were supposed to do. We have done this. We have reached step number one, which is getting range in terms of time of flight. Nayan, Abhiram, Akshay, Niharika, Tanu, Tarun, Vashant, are we there? Do we understand this? Raise of hands will give me more faith. Do we understand this? Yes. Yes, great. Nayan, I am waiting for you. Abhiram, Tanu, I'm still waiting for you. Okay, beta, good. What about y-axis? Let me make a question along y-axis. Uy is 0. Ay is minus g, matlab minus 10. Minus 10. Time is given as capital T. Time is given as capital T, and the displacement y. Displacement y is minus 20. Do we understand why it is minus 20? It's going from O to A. It is moving downwards and it is minus 20. Can I have some raise hand that gives me faith that this is correct, sir? Y is equal to Uy into T plus half Ay into T squared. This is the equation that I apply. Equation number two. Uy is 0, so this goes away. Y becomes minus 10. No, y becomes minus 20 is equal to minus half into 10 into T squared. You can solve this very easily. You will get T squared as 4, which implies T will be 2 seconds. Am I clear? Did you get this answer? T is 2 seconds. These 2 seconds is your answer for time of flight. Then I can use this time here and the range will be plus 10 into 2 plus 20 meters. That means it will fall 20 meters forward and it will fall after 2 seconds. Am I clear? Can I have some raise hand that we understand this, sir? Raise hands. Give me faith. Okay, I'll ask each of you individually, and I'll give you a chance to speak up. Now I allowed you to unmute yourself. Niharika, you have understood this, you have raised your hands. Nayan, can you say, tell me, have you got the answer, Nayan? You can unmute yourself and tell me. Nayan seemed not to be there. Akshay, you can unmute yourself and tell me if you have understood the question. Akshay. Akshay, you can unmute yourself and tell me if you have understood the question. Not there. Tanu, unmute yourself, please. Tell me if you have understood the question. If you can't unmute, at least raise your hands. Okay, she can unmute, she has raised her hand. Tarun, can you unmute yourself and tell me if you understood it? If you can't, please raise your hand. Tarun has also raised hand, he can't unmute himself. Vashant, can you unmute yourself? Tell me if you've understood the question, or you can raise your hand. Okay, Vashant has also raised his hand. That means he has also understood it again. I'll give you one more question for you to understand this. What I did in this question, I drew the diagram. I will not draw the diagram in the next one. You will have to draw it on your own. You have to write equation along x-axis. You have to write equation along y-axis and get the answer, I hope. I will see more answers in this question. And here comes the question. A body his throne. A body is thrown horizontally from top of a hill of height 45 meters, with velocity 15 meter per second. G has to be taken as 10 meter per second square. I will not write this. Find time of flight and R. That is your question. I've written it in short. I'm waiting for your answers. I hope you would be trying this question and giving me the answers. I'll wait for you. After 2 minutes, what I'll do is I will draw the diagram so that you keep on getting hints about how to solve this question. A ball is thrown horizontally on the top of a hill. I have changed the question from tower to hill. Doesn't make any difference. You're only concentrated on the height and not whether it is hill or anything else. Doesn't make sense, doesn't make any difference. Okay, I'll draw the diagram now to speed up things. This, as you can see, is ground. This is the hill. Looks like a tower. Doesn't make any difference. 45 meters is the height. Just thrown with initial velocity u, which is given as 15 meter per second. It goes and falls like this. We are supposed to find out this R and this T. I hope we are there with our answers. But to make equation along x-axis, and we have to make a question along y-axis. Anyone with an answer up till now? Vashan, Tarun, Tanu, Niharika, Akshay, are you trying the question? Okay, anyone got an answer? I will solve it. Time 3 seconds, Niharika, well done. Good. If time is 3 seconds, get me the value of the range. Plus 45 meter, plus indicating that it is in the forward direction. That is absolutely correct, Niharika. Well done, beta. Neharika, unmute yourself. Can you unmute yourself now? Neharika, can you unmute yourself? See if you can unmute yourself. Is the speaker working? Microphone working? Can you unmute? I don't think she can. Anyways, let me solve on the behalf of Neharika. She had done it correctly. Ux, initial velocity along x, it is shown horizontally, so this is ux. So ux becomes plus 15. Ax becomes zero, there is no acceleration. Time, let us call it as capital T. We'll apply the equation x is equal to ux into t plus half ax into t squared. Acceleration along x is zero, so this goes away. X ki jagah r comes, x is equal to r. Is equal to plus 15 multiplied by capital T. That is what I get from equation number one. Do all of you get this equation? Neharika, so obviously got it. Tanu, Tarun, Vashan, can you raise your hands and tell me that you got this equation? Nayan, can we have some raise hands? Akshay. Okay, good. So we got up till this point. If you got up till this point, you have done almost half of the problem, more than half probably. Now the only thing that is left is for you to make equation along y-axis. Can you make the equation along y-axis? To make the equation along y-axis, your initial velocity along y is zero. Acceleration along y is definitely minus 10, minus because it is downwards. I have not written the units. Time, I have assumed it as capital T. We have to find the value of this capital T. Value of Y, which is displacement along Y axis. See, it is going from point O to A, like this. The displacement along Y axis is 45. But it is downwards, so it is minus 45. I'm not writing units. Y is equal to uy into t plus half ay into t squared. Y key value is minus 45 will be equal to uy is zero, so this goes away, minus 10 by 2 t squared. So from here, you will get t squared as 9, or t is equal to plus or minus 3. It cannot be negative because time is never negative. T is equal to 3. You get the value of t is equal to 3. Put it here. R becomes plus, plus indicating outside along positive x, plus 45. This is how you get your answers. Am I clear? Am I clear with this? Now, the question is, sir, if we do all the questions like this way, it will take a lot of time. And as I always told you, in case of need, you may not have so much time. Now, all the questions have to be done this way. This is the only way of doing it. But if you have less time, then all students ask me, sir, give us some tips, some shortcuts, so that I can solve the question correctly, quickly. But tips cannot be created out of the blue. I do not have a magic wand that I create a tip out of a magic wand. What will I do to create a tip? Is that I will squeeze this equation. And instead of this equation, I'll give you a formula. The problem with that tip is, if you don't remember it correctly, if you don't remember where it is applicable, you will make a mistake. But it is my duty my humble duty to give you that trip or trick. If you can remember it for horizontal projectile, you don't have to do this entire thing and go let go this entire thing. And you can just remember the main point. What is the main point? The main point is already here that we have written. See, there are two things that are asked. One is time, which I have now again marked in green. And one is the range, which I again mark it in green. Now, these are the two formulas that we have derived using equation along x-axis and equation along y-axis. If you don't want to do this entire thing of making the equation again and again and again, what you do is remember these two formulae. Remember these two formulae. And what are these two formulae? So now, I'm again going to write this question. If I have a question like this, if I have ground like here, and if I have something thrown from a height h, please draw this diagram. I hope you are making notes. Even if you are not making notes, pay your attention here. After the class, I'll be sending you the entire PDF. So don't worry. Remember what we are doing here. You have a height h and you are throwing a ball horizontally or a body horizontally from that height h. It will come and will strike like this. It will take some time. Let us call that time as t. And let us call that range as R. Now, what we will do, instead of using all the equations, we know the result of this equation. We know the result of this equation. The result is time is root over 2h by g. So I'll just write the formula for time. Time is root over 2h by g. So this is the formula for time that you have to remember without using any equation. Straight away you can use this. To find the value of range, you can multiply u by t. This is one way of remembering it. Multiply range, multiply u by t, or if you want to put the value of time, you can remember range as u multiplied by 2h by g. There are benefits and there are disadvantages. The benefit is, if you remember it correctly and you apply it correctly, you'll get the answer very fast, very quick, instantly. If you don't remember it, if you make a mistake, you will end up losing all marks. So that is a risk that comes with remembering a formula. Many a time a student tells me, sir, we have learned physics, but there are too many formulas. I just can't remember them. But there are not too many formulas. The only thing that we have done up till now is just use equations of motion. Three, not even three, we have just used two. V is equal to u plus at and s is equal to ut plus rvt square. All the formulas that you see in mechanics, in kinematics, are derived from these two equations. Either you can spend some time and get your answers from the original equations. If you want to save time, then you'll have to remember the different formulae for different cases. You can make different formulae for different cases, but then depending on the number of cases, your number of formulas will also go up. And that is a disadvantage. So if you think that your brain is going to help you by remembering things, by remembering formulae, remember them. If you think that, no, sir, I'm not very good at remembering, but I can derive them very quickly, you can use the derivation tariqa. Do we understand what I'm saying, or it is going above our heads? Do we understand this, that if you can remember these formulae, we can solve the question instantly without doing anything of x-axis and y-axis? Can I have some raise hand that we understand this? Niharika, Tarun, Tanu, Akshay, Nayan, Vasant, I'm waiting for everyone. These are these formulae now becomes your trick, now become your shortcut. And then I will try to solve one or two questions based on this shortcut. So I'll just, instead of writing the entire question, it will take time. I'll just draw the diagram and ask you the answer. Just draw the diagram and ask you the answer. So this is ground. Something is thrown. From a height of 80 meters with the horizontal velocity of 25 meters per second. So I've thrown this ball with a horizontal velocity of 25 meters per second. It falls on ground. What is the horizontal range? And what is the time of flight? Your time starts now. Your time starts now. Anyone with an answer? You can obviously do it with the old method, the original method of making equation along X and Y. But now I want you to be using what we have just now learned as trick or shortcut, short formula, tips and tricks to solve question in a flash. You've learned these tricks. I told you the trick. Can you give me the answer now? I am patiently waiting for your answers. I'm not getting any answers. Time, Niharika, is 4 seconds. Absolutely correct. What about the range? Time is definitely 4 seconds. Tanu, where are you? Are you solving the question? Tarun, Vasant, Akshay. Akshay never talks. Vasant. So how do you go about doing it? Plus 100, Niharika, you are correct. So now instead of doing is X and Y and all thing, I'll just put the formula of time of flight. Time of flight is root over 2H by G. If you can remember this, you just use it. Root over 2 into height is 80 divided by 10. You will get it as root over 16 and your answer will be 4 seconds. So you got your answer in a flash. How could you do it? This is no magic. This is no trick. This is no tip. It's simple that we remember that formula. That's it. To get the value of range, you multiply U with T. Now it becomes very easy because you know U. U is 25 plus because it is forward, whatever. Into time of flight. Time of flight is 4. And you get your answer as plus 1. Do we all agree on this? How we got this? Can I have some raise hand that we understand this, sir? This is not a new method. Niharika, Tanu, Tarun, Vasant, Abhiram. Abhiram, I think, has left, not able to join back. Maybe problem with his laptop. Nayan, still to get any response from Nayan and Akshay. I don't know. So, this is how you do it. Can I give you one more? The last one for today. I will wind up the class and we'll wind up this chapter on projectiles. And then we'll move on to a very interesting one, relative velocity. Move on to that. Okay, question. Again, I will not draw, I will not write the question, I will draw the diagram. So this is a hill. We have thrown something from the hill. 5 meter per second is the velocity. No. Let me make the velocity as 20 meters per second. You have thrown something horizontally from a building of height 125 meters horizontally. It will strike the ground. What is the range? And what is the time of flight? That is the question. I hope all of us get the answer for this one. I'll also give you a homework question after this. We'll winding up. And I'll expect that you will solve the question for homework and put your solutions in the group. Yarika now has done it in exceedingly quick time. 5 seconds. Yes, Beta, that is the answer. 5 seconds, that is the answer. Correct. What about the range? What about the range? Plus 100 meters, that is absolutely correct, Beta. Good one, Beta. God bless you. You are doing a lot of hard work. And I'm sure the Almighty is having a look and you will get good results for that. Time of flight, you can straight away use the formula 2h by g, and I would urge all students to take some inspiration from Niharika. She has been doing a lot of hard work and the results will definitely show this. And I urge all of you to do the same. 2h by g, just put the values 2 into 125 divided by g is 10. I think you will get root over 25. The time becomes 5 seconds. Did we all get this, everyone? Did we all get this? You get the value of range, you can multiply u with t, which you can very easily do now. U is plus 20 because it is in the plus x direction. Multiplied by 5, you will get plus 100 meters. So the range becomes plus. Our range becomes plus 100, or you can simply say 100 meters, and the time of flight is 5 seconds. I'll give you one winding question for your homework that you will have to solve. Question for homework. And this is as simple as it gets. I'm throwing something, a ball with a velocity of 5 meters per second from a top of a tower. Five hundred meters tall. I have thrown something with a horizontal velocity of 5 meters per second. Where it falls, you have to tell me the range and you have to tell me the time of flight. That is your homework question. I'll wind up today's class with a quick recap of what we had done. The topic of discussion today was horizontal projectile. We had seen what an oblique projectile is. You throw something at an angle. That is an oblique projectile. Throw something vertically, of course, that's a vertical projectile. We have discussed this in motion in 1D. If you go on the top of a building or a tower or a hill and you throw something horizontally, that becomes your horizontal projectile. Normally, the things that are known are U, H, and G. The unknowns are T and horizontal range. We have seen how to solve it. by making equation along x-axis, equation along y-axis. When you make equation along x-axis, you get r is equal to u into t. When you make equation along y-axis, you get t is equal to root over 2h by g. You can solve the equations using the formula, if you can remember it, or if you don't remember the formula, then always solve it by making equations of motion along x and y. This is where we end today's class. I have saved this PDF. I'll be sending it to you right after this class. Anything else, please let me know. I've given you question for homework. This is the question that you got to do for homework. A ball is thrown, the velocity of 5 meters per second from the top of a tower 500 meters high. Put the solution on the Telegram group. We'll discuss it there. Until next time, we finish this topic. We'll be moving on to the next topic, which is relative velocity. See you in the next class. Bye-bye, everyone. I hope everyone stays safe, stays healthy, and happy. Bye-bye.